Jokes aside, hello guys, I'm finally posting another Royale High video. Make sure to smash that like button, subscribe, and turn post notifications on if you haven't already. Also, make sure to like the video because why not? But anyway guys, today's video is going to be revolving around how to turn profit into halos. Now, this is a complicated, but at the same time, not complicated thing to do. It sounds more complicated than it actually is. So the first thing you're going to do, let's say you have an item or a halo or diamonds even. It does not have to be anything special. Any of these items could work, literally any item. And what you're going to do is you're going to try to trade for a better item. For example, you're going to take that diamonds and you're going to trade for an item that's pretty high in demand. You're going to buy an item that is high in demand. And then you're going to sell it, even if it's not very high in demand. Like, I recommend trying to buy, like, for example, the baby doll dress. Try to buy it for, like, 10K or something. And then try to resell it for, like, 25K or 20K or 17K. So that profit will build up in your inventory. You're basically getting 7K for free, or however many diamonds you earn in profit. Even if it's 100 diamonds, trust me, it will be very useful in the future. So now when all those diamonds or all of those items or halos pile up in your inventory, let's say you sold it for more than you paid, now your diamonds are going to be piling up until you can afford a really high in demand item, which is what you want to do. Now with this high demand item, you're either going to keep doing it until you get multiple high demand items and then trade them for your dream halo, or you're going to just trade them. Whatever you want, really. But you also have to be really smart that you don't lose value. And here's how to trade items that you're very, like, you love so much you want to hold on to. If you have items that you really want to hold on to, only trade them if you get an overpaying offer. Now, if you're getting a fair offer or an under offer, just decline, it's fine. Especially if you really love this item and you wear it a lot. But if you get an over offer, I 100% recommend to accept the offer. And here's how to know if it's an over offer or not. See how much your item's in demand, see how much it's in diamond value, see how much people want it, and see how much people have it. If it's really rare, if not a lot of people own it because it's off sale, if it's high in demand, and if it's in a really high diamond value, you want the person to offer around the same rate. If you see the person offering things that are even higher in value, accept. If you're seeing people, if you see people who are, like, offering you things that are less in value, decline. Okay, I just wanted to say a couple things. Of course, you don't have to accept the person's offer, even if they're over and you're attached to it. It's just highly recommended by me, but you don't have to. Also, remember, you can start off with the cheapest item. It doesn't have to be a halo.
Getting things for free by profiting and being smart about your trades. Also, guys, do not overpay for an item back. Let's say you traded one of your favorite items for a really high overpay. Do not go to trade double or triple for to get that item back, because now you're just losing profit and you're not going to get anywhere losing profit. You're literally going to go down. Make sure to make smart choices, and I'll see you all in the next one.